And today is the big, big day. Karnataka votes today after weeks of high-voltage campaigning, which saw Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Congress President Rahul Gandhi even trading charges. The state will vote today for a new government. It is the last major state held by the Congress, with the BJP trying to wrest another big opposition-ruled state and also regain their only gateway to the south. Opinion polls predict it will be a close fight, which could give regional party Janata Dal Secular a chance to play an important role in government formation. Voting will take place between 7 and 6 p.m. in 222 of the 224 constituencies. Now, Rahul Gandhi tweeted earlier, "I appeal to all office bearers and workers of the Congress party in Karnataka to provide all possible assistance to those affected by the heavy rains. Our polling booth teams must remain alert and help voters facing difficulties in reaching polling booths tomorrow." This was yesterday when there was rain, heavy rain in certain parts of the state. The Prime Minister also tweeted, "Urging my sister and brothers of Karnataka to vote in large numbers today. I would particularly like to call upon young voters to vote and enrich this festival of democracy with their participation." So this was the Prime Minister's tweet today. And Yediyurappa was up early. He visited a temple as well and offered prayers there. And let's just take a look at what he had to say.
"Only thing, vote for BJP, vote for democracy. Because people fed up with Siddaramaiah's government. We want to give very good government. So let them, all the people support BJP, and we are going to get 150 seats. And we are going to form the government on 17th.
All right, let's go across to Maya Sharma now, who's been reporting through these elections to the length and breadth of Karnataka. And Maya, you're going to be casting your vote this morning. And to say that the stakes are high in these elections is inadequate. It's the Congress trying to hold on to this last major state and the BJP trying to return to Karnataka, their only foothold in the south.
Oh, that is correct. The Karnataka election is being taken so seriously, very, very seriously indeed, by the national parties, the BJP and the Congress, and also, of course, the JDS here locally. It's a big day for the state. I'm all set. I've got my genuine voter ID card and my voter slip, and I'm just about to vote here on at this village on the outskirts of Bengaluru. And we also have some very keen voters lining up to be the first ones to vote. So, all set. So, Madam, you were first ag bandidiri. Tumba mukhyavagi idya voting madike. Madlebekalva. Sir, niwe first to. So, tumba important a voting madike. Madlebekalva. Okay. And you're turning out here bright and early in order to vote.
Yes. Very absolutely very important. Super important.
Super important. And this has been a high stakes election for Karnataka. Lots of big campaigners coming here.
Yes, and I want to be right here to give my vote.
To give your vote as well, so certainly a big issue. I mean, many urban voters actually don't come out to vote.
I know, I think it's really important, and especially with the younger generation, to come out and now really stake their claim for how they want their country to, you know, prosper and grow.
Absolutely, hugely important to vote. Sama? Niu yavaru inda badidre?
Ideyavaru.
Ideyavara? Okay, so niu vote madlebekalva?
Vote madlebeku.
Madlebeku. Okay, so the general consensus here of these early voters, voting just about to start here in this village of Banjarpalya, it's hugely important to vote. Now, 222 seats will be voting today, not the 224 full complement. Why? Because, well, one of the candidates, the BJP candidate in South Bengaluru, in Jayanagar Vijayakumar, he died. But also the voting in Rajarajeshwari Nagar constituency has been put off following the discovery of thousands and thousands of voter ID cards mysteriously in a flat in Jalahalli. So the voting there has been put off. The BJP blamed the Congress for that. The Congress tried to blame the BJP. But the result is no voting in Jayanagar, no voting in Rajarajeshwari Nagar either. So 222 seats will be voting today. A huge amount of security in Bengaluru and across the state as well. Thousands of booths, thousands of people getting ready in schools like this across the state to vote for Karnataka. The day is finally here after a rather bitter, very long and rather bitter campaign to see who will be ruling Karnataka for the next 5 years.
All right, Maya, we'll just let you go to cast that vote. But finally, what is the weather like? That's been a big worry. Just the day before, we had those heavy rains and more rain predicted for today.
It has indeed been a worry because last night The night before that, there were huge thunderstorms. And today there has been light rain predicted. Right now, the sky is blue, which looks encouraging at least for the voting, because voting starts at 7, but it goes on till 6 o'clock. Yesterday, the rain started early, soon after 5 p.m., so we're hoping that it doesn't come down and spoil voting day. But for now, the skies are blue, the weather is good, and hopefully voters across the state will be able to vote without the trouble of rain, the summer rain, causing a lot of inconvenience last night and the night before that.